Hi everyone and welcome back. So we will take a look on to another example in this video. Like we'll just have three different schema model and we'll try to define the association between them. So consider something like that: user, task and tool, where task belongs to user, means task will have a foreign key user ID there. User has many tasks, means a user ID can be there in a multiple task, single user ID can be there in the multiple task, and user has many tools, that means a single user ID can be there in the multiple tools. So user table doesn't have any foreign key, task table has a foreign key as a user ID, and the tools table has a foreign key as a user ID in this case. So how to deal with this tables and all? So these are the three defined schema models we have created: user, task and tool, where task belongs to user. And user has many tasks, means user ID can be there in the multiple task, and user has many tools, means same user ID can be there with the multiple tools. So while when we are running this, we will get to know this particular data. So you can see the users is a whole lot of list, and tools, which is the user ID is there. Similarly, in the we have the task, user ID is being working as a foreign key here. Okay. Now further, this is called eager loading. Here we haven't provided any references, and we are just trying to get the another associated collection and associated model using find and find all query. So find all include user. So whenever you are trying to find a task, for each and every task you will get a user object. User dot find all include task. So the same thing is, whenever you try to get a user, that will include the task associated to that user. Okay, user.findAll includes model, tools and instruments. So whenever we do user.findAll, with each user object you will also get the tools associated with that user, because tools has the user ID as a foreign key inside it. Similarly, task has a foreign key as a user ID in it. So whenever we get the task by task ID, we can also populate the user data belong to that particular task. So rest is just a bootstrap bulk create. Here we are doing a task.bulk create, and similarly the tools.bulk create, and it's up and running. Now, till now we are just writing everything inside a single file. So is there any opportunity where we can put all these schema models like user, cart, product, product category, inventory, all these kind of MySQL table models into a separate folder, and whenever we start our application, that gets executed and give us the up and running database tables. Okay, that we will take a look on to the second video, another video, how we can create a config.js, because here we are right now we are hard coding the MySQL connection details, but it can be retrieved from the config.json. So we'll just create a new folder, and inside config we can have a config.json. I mean, when we talk about the MySQL Sequelize documentations, all these things are there. So migration. So what we need to maintain? We need to maintain one particular config.json. Here you provide all your information and details. You can create all these things using Sequelize init. So Sequelize init command will give us. Config.js already exists, so it is unable to fail to create that. We just wanted to use development as an environment. So pass all your details. Database name is cart.db and host is localhost, dialect is MySQL. That's it, enough. Okay, what else we can have? We just need to have a config.json. And till now, how we are creating the database is just tables is just using Sequelize.sync, right? This is not the production view of creating the tables. We will just write the seeders and migrations to create the tables, and seeders to seed the data inside the tables. So you can also create, we can use npx, which will point to the local node modules of Sequelize. When you write this particular snippet, what it will do, it will generate, unable to find. So what you need to do, we need to create a migration, Sequelize init. Host override it. Okay, so you can see all the folders has been created. The migration folder has been created, seeders folder has been created. Now this particular command where I'm creating the migration for user, to create a user table with the first name and last name. You can see in the migration now, I see this data. Now this is a magical data, and you need to focus on this particular thing. And because Sequelize moves around the seeders and migrations where you can write your custom code, all the things. So here you can see the user collection, user model has been created, and it is having ID, first name, last name, email, created at, updated at are the defaults, up and downs, right? So this is way, this is how the migration gets created. Other things are like, you can also create how to run the migration, npx sequelize db migrate. So before that, we also need to provide the config details properly. By default, it will point to, let's write it out. I know it will fail. So we are just playing around it. So migrations are nothing but another way of creating the database tables. So like new database table I need to introduce. So I will be running this migration, sequelize.create table users with all these columns, right? So npx db migrate, right? So what it is doing, enable to resolve mail sequelize ORM. Okay, I need to go to the part 2. DB migrate, right? Using password, no. Using a normal development, access denied for user. Let's go there, config.json. Host is a local host. Password, I have a cartdb, and I have a MySQL running in a Docker container. So I can just put it. So what DB migrate will do? Unknown database, open the aliases, I'm not putting properly, it's cartdb. You can see create user has been created. Similarly, like we did a create, right? So I can use these kind of migrations to create another tables. So my name is user, I can create a post. Okay, attribute is like title and description. We don't need other attributes here. Title, string title. That's enough. Okay, we created a title. Now we can create another Sequelize migration to define the association between both these columns, both these tables, right? So you can see create user, create post. It's valid. It's easy, right? It's quick step. We just create the migrations, and now you just run the migration to create this table in the system. What happened? My system a little bit stuck, I think. So which command we have executed? Npx db migrate. So it will migrate the second one, create post, right? And if you see in the database, you will see the magic happening. So here we created users is a table we have created, I think, and there is one Sequelize meta is a table created automatically by the Sequelize. It keeps track of what all migrations you have already executed, right? So here we created a posts and we have created a user. So these two tables we have created. Similarly, we will write seeders and all. We will take a look onto that in the next video.